If you like the video, please subscribe Technical PCT channel and click the bell icon to get the latest videos.
Three are identical. Okay, now the delta value, therefore delta, that is delta is equal to zero. Let me consider that delta is equal to this, delta is equal to this, this value is equal to this, then it has to be this. Okay, over. The question is over. In this exercise, you will have 14 questions. In these 14 questions, 1-4 marks question is compulsory, and these are very easy to do. Right? Observe this one carefully. I am going to repeat it. By using the properties of determinants, he asked you to prove that the determinant is equal to zero. So C1 changes to C1 plus C2. X plus A, Y plus B, Z plus C. A, B, C, X plus A, Y plus B, Z plus C. Now, C1 and C3 are identical. That means same. Therefore, the determinant value is equal to zero using the property in the determinant. If any two rows or any two columns are identical, then the value of the determinant is zero. So, write on this one. And copy the next problem. Prove that delta of A minus B, B minus C, C minus A, B minus C, C minus A minus B, C minus A minus B, B minus C is equals to zero. Copy this one. And how to do the problem is important. Yes, hope you wrote that question, right? Now, take LHS, this is delta is equals. Okay, let delta is equal to LHS. Now, which operation is to be done to make that entire determinant is zero? Observe once, take 1 minute time. And think individually, don't see any notes or anything else, observe it. What are the properties? You just recall all the properties I have given yesterday. There are 6 properties. By using any one property, can you make the determinant as zero? Observe it. Suppose row 1. Changes to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That means if I add these 3 rows, or you can do in the second method, like C1 changes to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay, then you are going to get the answer. Observe. Delta is equal to delta of C R1. Changes to R1 plus R2 plus R3 means A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A. The entire get cancelled and you are going to get zero. Here also B minus C plus C minus A plus A minus B, zero. Here also C minus A plus A minus B plus B minus C, zero. Here I have changed only R1, R2 and R3 should not be disturbed. So it becomes B minus C, C minus A minus B. It becomes C minus A, okay, A minus B, B minus C. Yesterday I have given you the second property or third property, I don't know exactly, but observe it. In any determinant, if entire row elements, one row is zero or one column is zero, then the value of the determinant is zero. Here you should write the property. Since R1 is zero, then R1 elements are zero, then delta is equals to zero. What is the property here? In a determinant, if any row or any column is zero, then the value of the determinant is obviously zero. I am repeating this problem. Observe it. Sir, you can ask me, sir, can we use any column operations? Obviously, you can. Here, I am going to do the second method. Observe it is, if it is possible. Okay. Second method. Same. C1 changes to C1 plus C2 plus C3 if you do. C1 changes to C1 plus C2 plus C3 if I do. Delta is equals to delta of, observe, A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A. This becomes zero. A, B minus C plus C minus A plus A minus B, this is zero. C minus A minus B plus, this is also zero. That means you got the first column as zero and second column should not be disturbed. This is B minus C, C minus A minus B, and this is C minus A minus B, B minus C. That means if delta is equals to zero, that is equals to, that means entire column one is zero here. Now itself I said, in a determinant, if any one row or one column is zero, then the value of the determinant is equals to zero. Since you should write the reason, since C1 elements are zero, delta is equals to zero. Okay, no. You can do any one method in these two. Copy that one. If you want, copy that both methods. Next problem it is delta of 2, prove that delta of 2, 7, 65, 3, 8, 75, 5, 9, 86 is equals to 0. Observe this one. How to do this problem? I hope you have copied this problem. So I am going to rub it. You just, within the time I rub the board, you just observe the problem LHS and get an idea to get zero. I hope you got the idea how to track that one. How to get the value is zero. I hope you are all writing the notes. Please write the notes. Don't misuse. Yes, how to do the problem? Observe that one clearly. And I am going to consider this one as delta is equals to yes, observe here. C3 changes to C3 minus 9 into C2. Observe delta is equals to, I am changing C3. Okay, you just keep C1 and C2 as it is. That means 2, 3, 5. 7, 8, 9. Now, 65, C3. 65 minus 9 into C2 element, 7. 65 minus 63, I think you are going to get 2. Right? Now, you can write that rough aside of your problem. Now, 75 C3 minus 9 into 8. 75 minus 8 9s are 72. It is 3. Right? Now, 86 minus 9 into 9. Okay, 86 C3 minus 9 into C2. 86 minus 81 is equals to 5. You can observe this one clearly. C1 and C3 are identical. Therefore, delta is equals to 0. Write down. Even write down the rough also. I hope you are all writing the notes. Please maintain the notes clearly, which is useful to you. In this exercise, only 14 questions are there. In these 14 questions, one question is going to come for 4 marks. So, write the notes very neatly. Here I am observing the participants, that means here I am observing the chat box. Some students are coming very late to the class, they can't understand the problems. So I insist you to be here at 2 o'clock exact. Yes, I think you understood this problem. You can do this in the second method also if you want. Observe. Sir, we are not going to get the idea of this much. What to do, sir? You can do with a simple operation called, shall I run this one? Observe. Delta is equals to this one. The first operation I am going to write. C3 changes to C3 minus C2. Like this. Afterwards, take 9 common, other way, C3 minus C1, best thing. So you are going to get delta of 2, 3, 5, okay, 7, 8, 9, okay, 65 minus 2, 63. 75 minus 3, right? 72. 86 minus 5, 81, right? Now, take 9 common from this one. Yesterday, last property I have given you, k times of like that. So, you can write this one as 9 into 7, okay? This one as 9 into 8, this one as 9 into 9. Then, I am going to take 9 common from this one, 2, 3, 5 as it is, 7, 8, 9 as it is. Suppose, if I take like this, 9 7s are 63, 9 8s are 72, 9 9s are 8. So, C2 and C3 are identical. Therefore, delta is equal to 0, even if you can take like this. But you should write here, taking 9 common from C3. Okay. Take down 2 methods. Which one you want, you can. No one. Write down the next problem. Show that delta 111 BC CA AB A into B plus C B into C plus A C into A plus B is equals to zero. I am repeating. Show that delta of 1, 1, 1 BC CA AB second column. A into B plus C, B into C plus A, C into A plus B is equals to zero. Now, think of the problem. Take 1 minute time and think of the problem slowly and get the answer. Observe that third column. In the third column, if you might, I will give you a hint, you just try once, okay? In the third column, AB plus AC, first element. Second element is BC plus AB. Third element is AC plus BC. Okay, that means I just multiplied the element outside into the bracket. Okay, now just add C2 and C3. Add C2 and C3 and take that element outside, you are going to get the answer. Of course, I am going to do on the board, don't worry. But try it. Please stop your video. I request you to stop your video, please. Yes. Observe this one. What I said? Just multiply. If I multiply these two, I am going to get AB plus AC. Am I right? So, I can write this one as AB plus AC. Now, BC plus AB. Now, AC plus BC. Okay. Observe. C3 changes to C3 plus C2. So delta of 1, 1, 1. C2 as it is BC, CA, AB. Add these two. AB plus BC plus CA, AB plus BC plus CA, AB plus BC plus CA. If you observe this one, you can take this entire element outside. Am I right? That means taking AB plus BC plus CA out, I'm going to get 1, 1, 1. Okay, second row, second column as it is AB, here 1, 1, 1. Why? Because entire element, this entire is only one element. Okay, we took this entire outside, I'm going to get 1, 1, 1. Yesterday itself, I have given you the property number 6, K into 1, 2, 3, example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is there. Okay, you can write that away as 1, 2, 3, 7, 4, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 7K, 8K, 9K. Here, we are having same 7K, 8K, 9K. I took K outside. I got 1, 1, 1 here. I hope you understood this. So, I took K outside like AB plus BC plus CA outside. And now observe C1 and C3. C1 and C3 are identical. Therefore, delta is equals to zero. Copy this. I am repeating this problem. In the question, I multiplied these two. That means, which is outside the bracket, I got this. And I added these two columns. Therefore, I got the third column like this. I took this entire quantity outside and the third column became 1, 1, 1 as C1 and C3 are identical. Delta value is equals to zero. Copy this one. Delta of 0 A minus B minus A 0 minus C BC0 is equals to 0. Copy this one and take 1 minute time to think of it. How to get right hand side 0? Delta is equals to this. You can do this problem by using two methods. The first method I am saying here, R2 changes to B into R2. I am multiplying with B. Okay. R3 changes to A into R3. That means I am going to get delta is equals to delta of 0 A minus B, right? And here, okay, you do what I will tell. Because if you multiply, I am going to get minus AB, 0, here it is minus BC, and here it becomes AB, okay, and BAC, 0. After that, if you add R1 and R2, sorry, R2 and R3, you are going to get the answer. Observe, right? Try this one by using these operations. Hope you got this step. 0 A minus B minus AB 0 minus BC. Okay. AB AC 0. Now add these two. R3 changes, R2 changes to R2 plus R3. I am going to get 0 A minus B minus this one in this one plus this one 0 0 plus this AC and this one becomes minus BC and this is AB obviously this is AC and this is 0 right. Now using the first column, yesterday we went through one property, property number 1. We can use any row or any column to expand the determinant. Using first column, expanding the determinant, we get AB into, why? Because this is 0, 0, 0 into anything will be 0, 0 into anything will be 0. Positive, negative, positive. So AB into, okay? Excluding this column and this row, you are going to get minus ABC plus ABC, minus ABC plus ABC. These two get cancelled. AB into 0 is equal to 0. Take down. You can do this problem in another method, of course, I will tell. Copy this one. Yes, I am going through the second method. Let us consider capital A is equal to, this is matrix, not the determinant. This is matrix, not the determinant. A is equals to 0, A minus B. Okay? Minus A, 0, minus C. Okay? B, C, 0. Okay? Now, you find out A transpose like this. What is A transpose? 0, first row as first column, A minus B. And here, minus A, 0, minus C. And here, B, C, 0. Am I right? Now, find out that A, we are having one formula. We know that. That means we know that we are having one formula. Det A is equal to det A transpose. Okay, that means if you find the determinant of both will be same. That means let me consider this is delta, which is also, that means this is observed. And I'm repeating, this is minus A. Na? If you observe this one carefully, you are going to get 0 A minus B. Minus A, 0, minus C, B, C, 0. Even you can write this one as A transpose is equals to, observe this one clearly, 0, negative A, and here it is B. So it is minus A. You are having one property applying on det determinant that A transpose is equals to minus det A. Okay? Here you are having one property that A transpose is equal to A det A. So det A is equal to minus det A. 2 into det A is equals to 0. Det A value is equals to 0. This is a method. You can do second method also like this. That is the first method. This is the second method. I am repeating this method. Capital A. Let us consider this is my determinant. Let capital A is equal to this. Find out the transpose of this one. A transpose is equal to, take minus common here, I am going to get A. So you can write A transpose is equal to minus A. Writing determinant on both sides. After that, you are having one property, det of A transpose is equal to det A. That means both are same. So det A transpose is equal to det A. You are going to get det A is equal to minus of det A. You will transpose this one there. 2 into det A is equal to 0, det A is equal to 0. Copy this one. Please switch off your video, please. Turn off your video, please. Turn off. Write down the notes. So these are the two methods which you can use to show that the value is equals to 0. Write down the next question. Write down the next question. Delta of minus A square AB AC BA, write down, minus B square BC CA CB minus c square is equals to 4 a square b square c square.
Observe this one. What is the RHS given to you?
You should concentrate on 4 a square b square c square. Okay, now take LHS, observe this. We can take A common from the first row, taking small a from R1. Okay, A is outside. And here you are going to get minus A, B and C. Okay. Now taking small b from R2, here it is B outside and you are going to get small a and here it is small b and here it is C. Okay. Now taking C from R3 outside. Okay, common. So it becomes small a and it is b and it is minus c. Now observe this one. You got a, b, c outside. Am I right? Now, if you observe this one clearly, a is there in the first column. So again, taking a from C1, that means already ABC is here. If another A comes out, it becomes A square. A square into minus 1, 1, 1. Okay. Taking B common from C2, it becomes B square. Okay. Now 1 minus 1, 1. Am I right? Taking C from C3, that means you are going to get 1, 1 minus 1. This becomes C square. Now using, that means expanding determinant using first row on R1, that means you are going to get A square B square C square into minus 1 into this column, this row over. So it is 1 minus 1, 0, minus 1 into this column, this row over minus 1, minus 1, it is minus 2. Okay. Now plus 1 into this column, this row over 1 minus of minus 1, it becomes. Okay, I am writing that one. I am repeating this again. Observe. I think you understood up to a square, b square, c square. Minus 1 into, exclude this column and this row, a, b, c, d, a, d, minus b, c. 1 minus 1. Okay, I am repeating. 1 minus 1. Minus 1 into, exclude this column and this row, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 again, plus 1 into, exclude this column and this row, 1 minus of minus, it becomes positive. So you are going to get a square, b square, c square into, simplifying this, it is 4, it is RHS. I am repeating this problem again. Observe this once. First of all, observe the first row. In the first row, you are having A total common. Sir, here itself we can write, taking A from C1, C2, C3 now. Okay, your wish, no problem. Taking A from C1. A is also here in C1, right? So, nothing to worry. I took from R1. Taking A from R1. I got this. Taking B from R2. I got this. Taking C from R3. I got this. Taking A from C1, C2, C3. Okay, I got this. After that, I expanded the determinant by using R1. Then I am going to get 4 right hand side. 4 into A square, B square, C square. Okay, do copy this one and tomorrow we will see. Have a good day.